Class of 2020, parents, guardians, relatives, Board of Trustees, school board members, superintendents, faculty, staff, and friends, it is my honor this evening to welcome you to the 151st Coe-Brown Northwood Academy Commencement. We will be spending some time together honoring a class who have a special distinction forever. Who would have thought we would have a fourth quarter plus with remote learning and remote living? To the class and parents, I would like to thank you for working together and supporting all during a very difficult time in our history, not only of our country, but of the world. I am so proud of our school community and especially the class of 2020 for persevering, guiding, and leading one another in a positive direction. We have a saying in our main lobby, attitude is everything. This year, we have been challenged to make every day as positive as we can and to the best of all of our abilities. I believe we have tried our very best to accomplish this goal. I have seen many students tested as well as their parents, families, and friends to manage continued support for one another. Even though we are not where we want to be in our society, we are closer to the end of that very, very long tunnel. This event has caused us all to focus on the most important people in our lives. We're so excited to honor this special group of young men and women, the class of 2020. Tonight, we will be discussing many honors, awards, scholarships, and hearing about our entire class. The most special award of the evening is the Individual Diploma of Accomplishment. A lot of our students have been awarded probably well over $2.5 million from schools of acceptance. The military have offered careers of high value as well as specific programs and apprenticeships. On your program, please notice the many students achieving honors in several different National Honor Societies and organizations. All seniors in gold reaching the 90 average or higher, please give them their deserved credit for 4 years of very hard work. You should be very proud of all your accomplishments. A special thank you to our faculty and staff for their incredible support of your class. The communities have been so supportive in helping and assisting the entire class of 2020 in many, many ways. I would also like to thank the class, faculty, and staff again for assisting in our celebration during the entire graduation week. Thank you. Would you please now rise for our national anthem, sung by Mirah, accompanied by Mr. Colby Baker.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
It is now my honor to introduce the class of 2020.
Thank you.
It is my pleasure to introduce the president of the class of 2020, Hayleigh McNeil.
Hello and welcome to the first ever virtual graduation for the class of 2020. My name is Hayleigh McNeil and I'm the senior class president. On behalf of my class, I would like to thank everyone for tuning in and watching as we celebrate our class in the most unique way. I want to bring my class back to last May, when I stood up in front of all of you and I said, I want to make our senior year the most memorable year yet. I promise when I said those words, this is not what I had in mind. This is by far the most unique graduation in the history of Coe-Brown. Whether we wanted to or not, coronavirus will define us. Although it will define the class of 2020, I believe that it will define us in the best way. Together, we are learning the hardest things at such a pivotal time in our lives. And I know that someday it will help us when something challenging comes our way. Together, we have learned to persevere through these uncharted waters, even though this is not the memorable senior year that everyone is hoping for. I can assure you that you will never forget your graduation. I believe that no matter what, we will all be present in each and every beautiful moment that we have in our lives because we'll never take anything for granted. I believe that the students of this class will be able to adapt swiftly through changes throughout their lives. On March 15th, we were told that we wouldn't be going back to school for 2 weeks. And a month later, we were told we wouldn't be going back at all. It was fast and unexpected. However, we tightened the sails and we pushed through the last quarter of our senior year. And we did it completely online. I hope that each and every one of you are proud of what you did despite this challenging time. I hope you remember how strong you are. I hope you remember to live in every moment like it's the last. I hope you never forget how determined you are to do anything in your life, no matter how difficult or impossible it seems. Although this is not the ending we were hoping for, the class of 2020 will not be forgotten. Now it's time that we make history. Congratulations to the class of 2020, and welcome to the first ever virtual graduation in Coe-Brown history.
It is my honor to now announce a number of scholastic awards earned by the class of 2020. We're happy to present the Academic Excellence Awards. English, Mirah Johnston. Vocational Technical Studies, Hunter Dakota. Science, Evan Lentz. Mathematics, Evan Lentz. Agricultural Education, Ashley Getchell. Business and Computer Studies, Shane Cameron. Visual Arts, Emily Dallaire. Spanish, Adeline Leifer. We have additional Academic Excellence Awards. Latin, Genevieve Melanson. French, Evan Lentz. Family and Consumer Studies, Madison Blaisdell. Performing Arts, Lauren Rose. Physical Education, Jared Pelletier. Social Studies, Emily Anderson. This year's outstanding female and male athletes are Catherine Messenger and Caden Donahue. The Headmaster's School Service Awards are presented to seniors who make significant contributions to the daily life of the Academy. This year we'd like to recognize Lauren Best, Riley Colby, Dawson Semperi Dubois, Ashley Getchell, Hayleigh McNeil, Alexandra Wheeler. The Daughters of the American Revolution present their DEAR Good Citizenship Award to Riley Colby. The Society of Women Engineers Certificate of Merit with highest honors are presented to Cordelia Norris and Michaela Power. In this year of strange occurrences and strange attendance at school, we'd like to recognize students who had exemplary attendance during their senior year. James Anderson, Landon Budney, Brianna Burke, Alexis Call, Riley Colby, Matthew Davis, Sydney Fenstra, Patrick Helm, Seth Howard, Dakota McPhee, James Noble III, Connor Nowak, Jacob Radwin, Eric Taylor. The following students had exemplary attendance all 4 years. Madison Crete, Adeline Leifer, Mary Toms. We have a number of students receiving scholastic awards for achieving honor roll status for 3 consecutive terms during the senior year. Caden Alberts, Isabel Allen, Trey Borden, Madison Bowen, Carissa Clary, Emily Delaire, Thomas Daly, Michaela DeButts, Sam Delfuco, Sydney Fenstra, Ashley Getchell, Jane Hammond, Natalie Harris. Continuing with achieving honor roll status for 3 consecutive terms during the senior year, Joshua Heckman, Cole Hodgson, Haley Holland, Seth Howard, Brianna Jackson, Dakota McPhee, Matthew Messenger, Hannah Monk, Kendall Nestor, Sam Pedersen, Abigail Pelletier, Caitlin Peralt. And additional students achieving honor roll status for 3 consecutive terms during the senior year include Anna Principato, Sophie Sabia, Dawson Semperi Dubois, Crystal Stalk, Madison Tatum, Willow Tritter, Lauren Vino, Mesgrim Wallace, Dylan White. Seniors receiving scholastic awards for achieving honor roll status all 4 years of high school include Hunter Adams, Emily Anderson, Seamus Baker, Lauren Best, Catherine Blake, Cody Boheen, Jaden Belanger, Ben Brieger, Brianna Burke, Shane Cameron, Riley Colby, Anthony Compte, Addison Craven, Lauren Curtin, Matthew Davis, Hunter Decoder. Continuing with achieving honor roll status all 4 years of high school, Hazel Dellario, Celia Fogarty, Olivia Fontes, Megan Frost, Colin Greer, Patrick Helm, Nathaniel Huckins, Shannon Jackson, Mirah Johnston, Owen Judge, Hayden Knight, Madison Crete, Sophie Laird, Raymond Lapico, Adeline Leifer, Evan Lentz, Elizabeth Libby, Kelly Linskin. And finishing with our list of students who received honor roll status all 4 years of high school, Haley McNeil, Genevieve Melanson, Catherine Messenger, Angelis Moss, Ryan Nestor, Cordelia Norris, Connor Nowak, Kelsey Pease, Jacob Radwin, Kathleen Roach, Lauren Rose, Mark Summer, Natalie Tate, Morgan Tatum, Mary Toms, Madison Tortella Lewis, Alexandra Wheeler. The salutatorian for the class of 2020, Hazel C. Dellario. The 2020 valedictorian, Evan J. Lentz.
Next, we are happy to share the senior video created by Lillian Broome, highlighting all of our seniors and some of the fun times they have had together.
Oh dear, I'm sorry that you grew up so soon. A cold year and no high school parties. I've been drinking alone. Oh, I've been drinking alone. So don't fear the warnings, the bitter of the most. 4 years of driving across the country for empty seats at their shows, and they've been drinking up.
Keep your eyes, be surprised, keep hungry. Stay alive, try to lose all of your money.
You, young, young blood. You, young, young blood. Young blood.
So when you're mad for no reason at everything at once, and when you start overthinking, I'll be drinking at home. Oh, I'll be drinking at home. So
keep your time, keep your mind, keep humble. Start your life in the middle of the jungle. You, young, young blood. Rub your eyes, be surprised, keep hungry. Stay alive, try to lose all of your money. You,
that this life takes a toll on you. I spend nights stitching up the loose threads of my soul. In the morning I'm bulletproof. And if you want, I can tell the truth. That this life takes a toll on you. I spend nights stitching up the loose threads of my soul. In the morning I'm bulletproof. In the morning I'm bulletproof. So keep your time, keep your mind, keep humble. Start your life in the middle of the jungle. You, young, young blood.
Rub your eyes, be surprised, keep hungry. Stay alive, try to lose all of your money. You, young, young blood. You, young, young blood. You.
Young blood.
me this, that you'll stand by me forever. But if God forbid fate should step in and force us into a goodbye, if you have children someday,
there are a number of words we could use to describe this young lady. Determination, courage, leadership, and an overwhelming spirit to succeed. It is my honor to introduce the salutatorian of the class of 2020, Hazel Dellario.
As I sit here writing this, just today, I have had to do 6 assignments, take the AP biology test, and write this speech, all while feeling sick. It reminds me of how, despite extraordinary circumstances, our class has had to buckle down and finish high school. I did not know that today I would have this huge amount of work to do, all while not feeling well. I only found out that it would take over my day until it already had, much like how we did not know we would be out of school until we already were. We had our last day together without even knowing it would be our last day, and that is truly tragic. After all the hardships we have been through to graduate, one last one would be thrown at our feet before the challenge was over. Many have pointed out that this is hugely disappointing, as we will never experience a traditional high school graduation, and it is indeed a loss for all of us. Many have complained that it is not fair, and that is undeniable, but life isn't fair. At the end of the day, what we have experienced this year makes us the most resilient class to come out of Coe-Brown. Like our various achievements over the last 4 years, our resilience was not easy to attain. It did not come to us overnight, and it was not handed to us by our elders. It was something that every one of us had to earn, and we all did that this year. The fact that you are participating in this ceremony, no matter what form that takes, proves that you have earned the title of the most resilient class of Coe-Brown. It may be easy to feel lost during these times. We have been planning to live in a world unmarred by communicable diseases our whole lives, and all of a sudden, our plans were smashed. We suddenly had to learn how to exist with these new parameters placed around us. Others were rigid and broke under the stress of such massive change, but we adapted and bent with the wind. We learned how to adjust to living alone and learning online. Coronavirus hit us with the weight of 1,000 bricks, but we didn't break. We simply changed shape. That is what proves that our class has what it takes to survive any challenges coming its way. It won't be easy to face what lies ahead. The pandemic is not over. College is full of new challenges. Working in this new economy will be difficult, and going into the military is as perilous as ever. Not to mention the other issues that our generation will have to face, like climate change, discrimination, and political unrest. What lies ahead is terrifying, but so is what lies behind us, and we made it through that just fine. A lot of older folks have worried about our generation, saying that we are too coddled to know what real hardship is, and that we could never understand living in fear or in scarcity. The class of 2020 has proved them wrong. We handled adversity with grace and elegance, and we will continue to do so in the future. If you, a parent, relative, friend, or even a member of the class of 2020 yourself, have ever wondered, how in the world are they going to make it? Worry no more. We can do anything because we already have.
Please join us in exploring the senior plans of the class of 2020.
Tonight, we are thrilled to be able to present a number of senior scholarships. Know that they are all given in great generosity from supportive individuals. By awarding scholarships, they are investing in the future education of our seniors. On behalf of the Board of Trustees and the Class of 2020, we honor the individuals and organizations behind these scholarships and thank them for their generosity. Emily Anderson is awarded the VFW Post 7217 U.S. History Scholarship. Lauren Best is awarded the CBNA National Honor Society Scholarship. Catherine Blake is receiving the Ralph Duke CV Jr. and Francis CV Memorial Scholarship, the Alumni Scholarship, the Northwood Fire Rescue Scholarship, the Harvey Lake Women's Club Scholarship, and the CBNA National Spanish Honor Society Scholarship. Jaden Belanger is receiving the Northwood Fire Rescue Association Scholarship. Benjamin Brieger is receiving the CBNA National Honor Society Scholarship and the Alumni Scholarship. Shane Cameron has been awarded the CBNA National Honor Society Scholarship and the Future Business Leaders of America Scholarship. James Cirillo is receiving the I Am College Bound Scholarship. Krista Cleary is receiving the George N. Kate Scholarship. Riley Colby is receiving the CBNA National Honor Society Scholarship and the Stratford Women's Club Scholarship. Addison Craven is receiving the Student Council Leadership Scholarship. Lauren Curtin is receiving the George N. Kate Scholarship. Matthew Davis has been awarded the Sunset Catering Scholarship. Hunter Dakota has been awarded the Denise Elliott Dennett Scholarship. Elizabeth Downer is receiving the CBNA Faculty and Staff Scholarship. Celia Fogarty is receiving the CBNA National Honor Society Scholarship and the Barrington Women's Club Scholarship. Nikki Frasca is receiving the CBNA Faculty and Staff Scholarship with special recognition. Ashley Gatchell is receiving the CBNA Faculty and Staff Scholarship. Natalie Harris has been awarded the Remembering Jesse Cormier Memorial Scholarship. Cole Hodgson is receiving the Brenda Lynn and Robert Daly Memorial Scholarship. Hayleigh Holland has received the Future Business Leaders of America Scholarship. Seth Howard has been awarded the George N. Kate Scholarship. Brianna Jackson is receiving the Denise Elliott Dennett Scholarship, the Beanhole Bash Scholarship, and the Harvey Lake Women's Club Scholarship. Adeline Leifer is receiving the CBNA National Spanish Honor Society Scholarship and the Barrington American Legion Post 114 Scholarship. Elizabeth Libby is receiving the CBNA National Honor Society Scholarship. Haley McNeil is receiving the Student Council Leadership Scholarship. Brenna Meeker is receiving the Harvey Lake Women's Club Scholarship. Ethan Meeker is receiving the Ann E. Hembelt Memorial Scholarship. Catherine Messenger is being awarded the Lemon Drop Scholarship, the George N. Kate Scholarship, and the Stratford Women's Club Scholarship. Matthew Messenger has been awarded the Lemon Drop Scholarship. Patrick Murray is receiving the Camp Yavna Educational Scholarship. Fiona O'Shea has been awarded the George N. Kate Scholarship. Anna Principato is receiving the Student Council Leadership Scholarship. Jacob Radwin is receiving the George N. Kate Scholarship. Kathleen Roach is receiving the Sunset Catering Scholarship. Riley Rogers has been awarded the Harvey Lake Women's Club Scholarship. Elizabeth Schultz is receiving the John and Gloria O'Brien Memorial Scholarship. Daniel Strum is receiving the George N. Kate Scholarship. Natalie Tate has been awarded the Barrington Women's Club Scholarship. Mary Toms is receiving the Seacoast First Savings Bank Scholarship and the Johnson Seafood and Steak Scholarship. Madison Tortorella Lewis is receiving the Barrington American Legion Post 114 Scholarship. Mescarum Wallace is receiving the Future Business Leaders of America Scholarship and the George N. Kate Scholarship. Alexandra Wheeler is receiving the Alumni Scholarship and the Nottingham Fire Rescue Association Scholarship Robert E. McKenney Memorial. The Pinkham Scholarship is saved for last, as it is an extremely generous scholarship awarded each year to a deserving senior. In 2005, the estate of Eleanor Polly Tasker Pinkham, class of 1940, bequeathed significant funds to be used in awarding scholarships. This year's Pinkham Scholarship is in the amount of $10,000. This year's Pinkham Scholarship is awarded to Kathleen Roach. Congratulations to Kathleen and all our scholarship winners.
I truly appreciate my opportunity this evening to introduce the valedictorian of the class of 2020, Evan Lentz.
I'd like to express that I wish I could have given this speech in person. It doesn't feel quite right to be saying these things over camera and having a virtual graduation. Our whole class deserves to have an in-person graduation. We deserve to hear our names called out, to physically walk up and grab our diploma so we can bring it close to the past 4 years. However, these aren't normal times we're in anymore, and we all have to try to make the best of what's available. I would also like to give a well-deserved thank you to the faculty and administration of Coe-Brown Northwood Academy. Personally speaking, my teachers have been more than accommodating, allowing me to shift my deadlines as needed, and they've put forth their best efforts to ensure my education continued as normal. I know that administration has worked tirelessly trying to give us all the feeling of closure we deserve, and I'm very grateful for their efforts to do so. I'm also appreciative of the fact that through these difficult times, administration has heard our concern and worked together with us to reach solutions. If any one of us were told last year that this is what the world would be like today, I think the vast majority of us would have laughed. None of us could have expected anything close to this happening, and it's safe to say that none of us will be soon to forget these past few months. This is really the first major historical event of our lifetimes. And with that, I want to stop talking about Corona. Our past 4 years should not be dictated by these past few months. It doesn't seem fair. Instead, I want to talk about the rest of it. All those times we've walked through the doors of Coe-Brown, met up with our friends, and then went off to class. All the times we got excited at lunch when we found out that there was a fresh batch of cookies. All the time we stayed up too late trying to finish that paper. All those normal days. That's what I want to focus on. So today, when you celebrate graduation with your families, I want you to think back. Share some of your favorite memories over the past 4 years and do whatever you can do to make today special. We all deserve to leave today with a feeling of closure, with a feeling that these past 4 years have impacted our lives for the better. So again, I ask you, make today special. Don't forget that today is about us. It's about our accomplishments, our efforts, everything we've done over the past 4 years. I'm going to leave you with this. Remember all the good times you had at Coe-Brown, and let those be the pieces of Coe-Brown you carry with you for the rest of your lives. And on that note, Coe-Brown, have a great Friday.
We now have to share with you a special video from the teachers and staff of Coe-Brown Northwood Academy for the class of 2020.
Congratulations to the class of 2020. We're so proud of you. We miss having you on campus. You were an unforgettable class prior to any of this, and now the class of 2020 is going to go down in history. I hope you have an amazing graduation experience, and I'm so excited for your next step in life. Be brave, take risks, have fun. Find good people to be around, and please, please, please keep in touch and let us know how you're doing. We love the class of 2020, and we wish you the best.
I want to share some advice that was given at my brother's graduation by Carolyn Heilbronn, a famous author. She said, wisdom is the courage to be who you are. And I want to wish you health, happiness, meaningful work, love, and that courage.
In high school, you have learned you have a voice. Now use that voice and go out and make a difference in the world.
I want you guys to remember how strong and positive you were able to stay during all of this. And I want you to remember how you banded together to advocate for each other, to advocate for yourselves. You did such an awesome job. So when the next hard thing happens in life, just remember how strong you stayed during all of this and remember that you can do it and you will do it.
Okay, be the change you want to see in the world. Instead of complaining about something, do something about it. Make it happen. You have a dream, you have a goal, go get it. Take action. Whether it's running a 5K or becoming an engineer, you can do it. Stay positive, work hard, make it happen. Class of 2020, Coe-Brown Bears, I could not be more proud. Miss Kennedy cares about you, she misses you, and she wishes you all the best in your future endeavors. Coe-Brown strong.
Congratulations, class of 2020, you guys did it. I wish you all the best. Thanks for all your hard work. Thanks for everything you've done for us and for the school. And I know there's probably a mix of emotions, happy, sad, a little bit of everything going on right now. If you're happy, wonderful. If you're sad, my wife loves this Jerry Seinfeld quote that pain is knowledge rushing in to fill a gap. So if you're feeling sad right now, look for the lesson.
Class of 2020, congratulations. My word of advice, find something you love to do, work really hard at it, and if you're lucky, you get to do it for the rest of your life. Best of luck. Love you guys. Hope to see you soon.
I just recently heard a saying, extraordinary times lead to extraordinary futures, and I really believe that's true. Each one of you has a bright future ahead of you, and even though you have different paths, you'll always be a part of the Coe-Brown community.
Every setback is a setup. Look at this as a springboard to launch you into your future. The best advice I can give you is find your passion. Find something you care an awful lot about and pursue it. With everything you have the potential. You just need to use it. You can do anything you put your mind to.
To the graduating class of 2020, we're so sorry that we had to end the school year this way. We really wish we could have been together. I'd like to wish you all the best of the luck. Congratulations on your achievements and wishing you all the best.
Congratulations to everyone in the class of 2020. You're going to be missed. Take care and stay safe. Congratulations.
Hey seniors, I miss you guys all so much already. You survived all my homeless outreach stories and all my grammar charts, and I love you guys, and I hope you come visit next year. Thank you.
Hi seniors, remember all the fun times we've had together? I wanted to wish you a very prosperous future, and be smart, and take care of each other, and stay safe.
Hi, senior class of 2020. All right, Mr. and Mrs. Gelzer, want to wish you a fantastic graduation.
And whatever the world brings you next, have fun.
Congratulations to the class of 2020. We'll miss you guys in Smith Hall.
Congratulations, class of 2020. It has been a pleasure knowing most of you through either FBLA, computer lit, business classes, Grand Estate Challenge. I appreciate getting to know all of you. Best wishes, and again, I hope our paths meet again, and I wish you the best of luck. Talk to you later.
I want to send you guys a message wishing you the best of luck with everything. Congratulations on graduating. And I just wanted to say that I miss teaching you guys face to face, and that you guys, the class of 2020, was the first real class that I got to know as a teacher. And I'm really thankful that you guys were the class, and you're a bunch of great people. And I wish you all the best of luck in your future endeavors.
Yes, if you can live through all of this and still come out on top like you have, you're all going to be just fine. To all the seniors, you are a unique group that has shown resilience, courage, and unity. Here's my best advice. Be kind, be healthy, be dignified, be great, be yourself, and be true. Congratulations, class of 2020. You did it.
Hey guys, really miss seeing all of you. Congratulations on your graduation. We're real proud of you.
Congratulations to the class of 2020.
Today, on this beautiful day, we have some special advice for you.
You can be a leader. You can be a follower.
As long as you take the plunge. Or you can take your own path.
Hey, senior class. 2020, Mr. Haggett here. Just wanting to say goodbye. You all left so soon, I never had a chance to say goodbye. As you can see, over the last few weeks, I've undergone a personal change. Nowhere to get a haircut. But that's okay, because it's a flashback to the 1970s. Three bits of advice I have for you. Endeavor to persevere. Make good choices. Work hard. And someday, you too can look this good. God bless.
Hello, seniors. I wanted to wish you all the best of luck as you head off into college, the workforce, the military, or wherever else life might take you. Heading out into the world can be really scary, but it's also super exciting, and I'm sure you're all going to do well. A little friend of mine also wanted to say goodbye. Many of you might know this guy. He's lived in my classroom through the year. He was picked up behind the science building from the road last fall, and he's also going to be heading off into the world soon. He's been living at home with me for the past few weeks, and he is very soon going to be heading out into Harvey Lake. We would love for you guys to come back and visit us sometime. And again, congrats to the class of 2020.
Is to never lose that tenacity and that hope and that joy to continue on. The years are full of many challenges, but you all have shown that you are able to rise to the challenge and succeed in ways that you never thought possible. Take those skills with you to college. Take those skills with you to the workforce. They will serve you very well. Know that everyone is rooting for you, and we wish you the most beautiful and happy and joyous life in your post-high school education years. Best of luck to all of you.
Hey, seniors.
Hey, seniors.
It's Mrs. Forward.
And Mrs. George.
We are here to wish you well and happy graduation. We want to know if you remember how proud you were when you got your sub perfect in the tank freshman year. That's how proud we are of you.
We hope that your future holds the same excitement that you had when you got your sub to be neutrally buoyant.
Hey, class of 2020. We just wanted to say
congratulations and good luck in the future.
Remember to always be grateful for all of the things that come your way. I know that this spring has been not as fun as you hoped, and so take advantage of all those milestones moving forward. Is that it?
That's it. Good luck, guys.
Good luck.
Hi, seniors. It's Miss Wheat. You know, besides sharing our love of our subjects, we tend to like to help guide you into adulthood. So, you know, we always have advice for you. And my bits of advice, always wear sunscreen, always get renter's insurance, and be kind to your fellow man. It's tough out there, but you're all gonna be great. And we miss you quite a bit. And congratulations on graduating. Bye.
Oh, the places you'll go. You have brains in your head. You have feet in your shoes. You can steer yourself any direction you choose.
And will you succeed?
Yes, you will indeed. 2020% guaranteed. Seniors, you'll move mountains.
So, CBNA class of 2020, you're off to great places. Today is your day. Your mountain is waiting, so get on your way.
Congratulations, class of 2020. We miss you.
Hi, class of 2020. Mr. Samuel, as you graduate and move on to the next phase of your lives, these are all the more responsibilities. It'll be daunting at times, and you may stumble or fail along the way. But keep at it. Eventually, you'll break through and succeed. Take pride in your work, and have empathy for others. We're all very eager to get to know you as CBNA alumni. It means a lot to hear from former students. We would love to hear from you, so please reach out to those teachers that impacted you the most. Congratulations to the class of 2020.
I guess as the class of 2020, you're expected to have the vision for the future. You've been adaptable, problem solvers, and thinkers, and this will lead to a positive contribution in our society. And I can tell you the one thing I can't wait to do is go back to the movie theaters and catch the Marvel movies this summer. We miss you all. Take care, and feel free to stop by.
Congratulations, CBNA class of 2020.
Hi guys, I miss you all. I hope you're doing well, and I'm really proud of the way you're handling such a difficult situation. I hope to see you soon, but until then, keep your heads up and be ready for all of the exciting opportunities and adventures heading your way. And just know your teachers at CBNA will always be here for you.
I'm so proud of who you are all becoming and the amazing things you've already accomplished, and I cannot wait to see what all of your futures hold for you. The best piece of advice I can give you is please pursue what you want to do, what is calling to you. If it's like making something stir in here, you need to pursue it and don't doubt yourself. You need to be nice to yourself and cheer yourself on and know that you are truly capable of whatever you put your minds to. We are going to miss you. We already miss you so much. Know that Coe-Brown will always be here for you. We love you. We are so proud of you. We miss you. Congratulations.
That's my hope for everybody in the class of 2020. No matter where you go, no matter where your path takes you, no matter what you do with your life, make every place better because you're in it. With your compassion, your intelligence, your persistence, your personal integrity, and your hope for the future. Take care of yourselves, take care of one another, and best of luck to all of you and all of your future endeavors. Congratulations again.
Hey, class of 2020. Congratulations on your graduation, and I wish you the best of luck going forward. Good luck.
I want you guys to know that despite all the challenges from COVID and social distancing, you guys will all go on to do amazing things, I'm sure. And it really is a great day to be thankful for all that we have, and it doesn't sound the same coming from me.
Class of 2020, here's what some of the gray stuff tells me to tell you. Pursue your passions. If you can turn your passions into your profession, that is fantastic. Otherwise, pursue them in your personal life because it will pay off. Number two, manage your relationship with fear. Recognize fear should be a part of your decision-making process, but don't let it dominate your decisions because you don't want it to get in the way of living life to its fullest. Number three, my mom always told me to lead with kindness, and kindness counts as good advice. Number four, guys, love big in whatever form it takes for you. Congratulations, class of 2020. Thank you so much for your contribution to the Coe-Brown community.
Class of 2020, we love you and miss you.
Congratulations to all our graduates.
And on that note, have a nice Friday.
Unlike most schools in the area, Coe-Brown is unique in that it is not run by a regular school board, but by a board of trustees. These trustees consist of dedicated community members who volunteer their time to make sure that Coe-Brown maintains the high standards of education that define it. At this time, it's my honor to introduce Timothy Joslin, the president of the Coe-Brown Board of Trustees.
Good afternoon. My name is Tim Joslin. I am the president of the Coe-Brown Board of Trustees. It is both an honor and a privilege to stand before you today. On behalf of the Board of Trustees, we welcome you to the Coe-Brown Northwood Academy Class of 2020 Commencement Ceremony. I extend a heartfelt welcome to members of the administration, faculty, staff, and most importantly, to our graduating students, your families, and friends. I would like to also give a special welcome to Assistant Headmaster Paul Davis, who is retiring this year after 42 years of service at Coe-Brown. His unwavering dedication for student success is commendable. Mr. Davis embodies the very culture and core values that we collectively instill in our community at Coe-Brown. You played an integral role in creating and maintaining high expectations at Coe-Brown for its students, faculty, and staff. The very standards that challenge them to be their best version of themselves each and every day. Mr. Davis, we are grateful for your dedication, your perseverance, and professionalism, and your endless support. Enjoy retirement, and know you'll always be a member of the Coe-Brown family. Thank you also to Diana Foster, Holly Gom, Elizabeth Lent, and Susan Murray, who are retiring this year as well. We all appreciate your many years of service and dedication to our students' success. Your legacy will live on at Coe-Brown as you venture into your next chapter. May your retirement bring your adventure, happiness, and back to CBNA for a visit now and again. Graduates, this is your day. A celebration of lessons learned, adventures shared, moments filled with special meaning. A farewell to old friends. Good times you have known together and gathering of memory to treasure. A beginning that is accented with uncertainty, but most assuredly, a time to look forward. To dream new dreams, set new goals, and reach new heights. On this day, graduates, we applaud you for your perseverance, your resilience, your fortitude. We are proud of your many achievements. We celebrate your successes. We look to your future with courage and hope. Be confident and proud of yourself as you graduate during this historic time and venture out on your own new beginning. On behalf of the Board of Trustees, administration, faculty, and staff, congratulations, Coe-Brown Northwood Academy Class of 2020. Well done.
I'm very proud to introduce Addison Craven, who is our final senior speaker tonight and has a few words for you as a farewell to the class of 2020.
When I think back to my first day of freshman year, it feels like an eternity ago. It's truly hard to believe that that shy, amateur, 14-year-old me, who is too nervous to talk to anybody on freshman orientation day, is the same me who's standing here right now giving this speech. Although it feels like a lifetime ago, it hasn't been. It's only been 4 years, less than a quarter of my life. To think that I've changed, learned, and grown so much in such a short time span is incredible, and it serves as a testament to the quality and value of my time at Coe-Brown. The friends I've made, the teachers who have mentored me and pushed me, the Winter Carnival stage events I've rehearsed for days and days with my friends, the basketball playoff games I've lost my voice at, and the awful cramps I've gotten from running sprints at volleyball practice are just a small sample of the memories that define high school in my mind. While not everybody in our class chose to play volleyball or stretch themselves thin with Winter Carnival events, I can assure you that each and every one of us has our own unique set of memories that will always linger in our minds as a symbol of the unforgettable experience that was Coe-Brown. As we are about to head out and begin the first chapter of our lives in the world beyond high school, it would be a lie to say that the majority of us aren't feeling nervous and unsure in some way or another. The prospect of leaving the comfort of home and venturing off to college or entering into the workforce or military, separated from all of our family and friends for the first time in our lives, is daunting. The uncertainty of it all is only made worse by the global pandemic that has so radically changed our way of life over the last couple of months. If high school has taught me anything, though, it's that these feelings will not last. If they did, I would still be the exact same kid that I was freshman year. Things change, people have experiences and adapt, and life moves on. 4 years from now, as I walk across that stage and receive my college diploma, I know that I will look back on the person that I am at this very moment and feel the same sense of embarrassment and surprise that I do looking back at my freshman year now. All of my classmates,
wherever their past in life may have taken them, will surely feel the same. I know that it's cliche to say that you will never forget your high school graduation, but for our class, I think we can all agree that we genuinely mean it. While these circumstances were not favorable and caused us to miss out on arguably the most important part of our high school careers, they showed us how valuable and precious our teenage years really are. They reminded us to be thankful for the things that we have and to not worry about the things that we don't have. So, as we turn this page in our lives and venture off into the real world, we'd like to say thank you to Coe-Brown and to everybody who has supported us along the way. You have shaped us into the people that we are today, and we will strive to make our mark in the world as you have made your mark in ours.
In closing this evening, the very special activity, please join me as you move your tassel from right to left. Congratulations to all graduates from the class of 2020.
The challenge, all you gotta do is leave it better than you found it. It's gonna get difficult to stand, but hold your balance. I just say whatever, cause there is no way you're round it. Everyone falls down sometimes, but you just gotta know it'll all be fine. It's okay, it's okay, it's okay. Up and nothing works, you feel surrounded. Gotta give your feet some gravity to get you grounded. Keep good things inside your ears just like the waves and sound it. And just say whatever, cause there is no way you're grounded. Everyone falls down sometimes, but you just gotta know it'll all be fine. It's okay, it's okay. Okay, hey, feeling good, like I should. When in dark, I walk around the neighborhood. Feeling blessed, never stressed. Got that sunshine on my Sunday best. Hey, feeling good, like I should. When in dark, I walk.